Hello friends, today we are going to discuss section 79 of the Indian Penal Code. Section 79 of the Indian Penal Code says, nothing is an offence which is done by any person who is justified by law or who by reason of a mistake of fact and not by reason of a mistake of law in good faith believes himself to be justified by law in doing it. So friends, section 79 says that nothing is an offence which is done by a person who thinks that he is justified by law when he does it. There is a difference between section 76 and section 79 of the Indian Penal Code. What is that difference? Section 76 says that nothing is an offence which is done by a person who is bound by law to do it, whereas section 79 says that nothing is an offence which is done by a person who believes that what he does is justified by law to do. So what is the difference? The difference is that under section 79 the word justified is used, whereas in section 76 the word bound is used. Now what is the difference between these two? The difference between these two is that bound means you have to do that act. If you do not do that act, there will be punishment for you and the action will be taken against you. So it is the meaning of bound. When we say that you are legally bound to do it, it means you have to do it. You have to do it. If you do not do that, then the action will be taken against you. As for example, we had taken that example in the section 76 when we had discussed that there is a police officer, there is a police inspector in the locality, and he knows that a person is roaming in my jurisdiction who is committed murder, who has committed murder. So the police officer is bound to arrest that person. Bound means the police officer will have to arrest that person the moment the police officer comes to know that the person is within its jurisdiction. If the police officer does not arrest him, the action will be taken against the police officer that why did you not arrest him. So he is bound by law to do it. But section 79, under section 79, the person is not bound by law to do it. But what he does is justified by law. What he does is justified by law. It means he is not bound to do that. It means if he doesn't do that, the action will not be taken against him. Nobody is going to ask him why you did not do that work. Why you did not do that act? Nobody will ask him. But if he does that act, then nobody will say that you have committed some wrong. So it is the meaning of the justified act. It is the meaning of the justified act. As for example, we will understand through illustration. What does illustration say? After going through the illustration, we will be able to understand it in a better way. So let us go through the illustration. The illustration says, A sees Z commit what appears to A to be a murder. A, in the exercise to the best of his judgment, exerted in good faith of the power which the law gives to all persons of apprehending murderers, in the act seizes Z in order to bring Z before the proper authorities. A has committed no offense, though it may turn out that Z was acting in self-defense. So illustration says that A sees Jet, A looks at Jet, Jet is committing some act. By looking at the act which is being done by Jet, A thinks that Jet is committing a murder. Now our law gives power to all the person that if somebody is committing an offense before you, you may apprehend him, you may arrest him, and after arresting him, you have to produce him immediately before the nearest police station or before the nearest police officer. So this is the law. this is the power which is given to all the persons in India, which is given to all the persons by our law. So when he looks at Jed, he thinks that the Jed is committing the murder, and A apprehends Jed, A arrests Jed, and after arresting Jed, A produces Jed before the proper authorities. Proper authorities means the police officers. So here A has committed no offense, though later on it turns out that Jed was not committing the murder, rather Jed was acting in his self-defense. So A has committed no offense. A has committed no offense because what A thought? A thought that Jed is committing a murder. So A has committed no offense. Why A has committed no offense? Because it is justified. It is justified to arrest a person if a person is committing a murder. It is justified. Now, again, we have to understand what is the difference between the word justified and bound. If Jed is committing murder, A is not bound to arrest him. A is not bound to take him into custody. You must have seen that in the Delhi or in so many localities. When an offense is committed, so many people just keep watching the offense. So many people keep on watching the criminals do offense, but nobody comes forward to save the person, to save the victim. Nobody comes forward to arrest the criminals. The criminals in daylight commit crime and just they go scot-free. So nobody arrests the witnesses. Nobody takes action against the witnesses because they are not bound to arrest the person. They are not bound to save the life of the victim. But if they take upon themselves to save the life of the victim, and in order to save the life of the victim, if they attack on the murderers, they attack on the criminals, and the criminals get injured, or even the criminals die because of the assault which is committed upon the criminals by the person who want to save the victim. So there is no offense because their act is justified. Though they were not bound to do that, but because they thought that we must save the victim, we must arrest the criminals, so if they have done so, they have committed no offense at all. The illustration deals with the second part of the section 79, which says that if a person, by reason of the mistake of fact and not by reason of the mistake of law, in good faith believes himself to be justified by law in doing it, that thing is not an offense. So illustration also deals with that, because there was a mistake of fact on the part of A. In fact, the Jed was committed in self-defense, but the A thought that Jed was not committing in self-defense, rather Jed was committing the murder. So though it was a mistake of the fact, but in good faith means with due care and attention. In good faith, A believes that Jed was committing the murder, and because of the mistake of facts, A apprehends Jed. So A has committed no offense. So this was section 79 of the Indian Penal Code. Tomorrow, I'll come with section 80 of the Indian Penal Code, but that will be in Hindi medium. Your own advocate, Sunil Kumar. Be happy. Be happy.